So welcome back to another video of Why Nobody Plays, a series where I highlight and talk about the pros and cons of playing some of the least picked legends in Apex Legends and how their kits can be buffed to bring up their pick rates. And today we're talking about everybody's favorite Bubba Man,
Gibby.
Gibby is currently one of the least picked legends in the game, but I know you're gonna say about Playboy Susuke. He's a must have pick on your team in high rank gameplay and competitive Apex such as ALGS. Exactly, ALGS, a competitive tournament that pro players play. He's a must have pick in pro play and not casual Apex. So what are the pros of playing Gibby? They are so much and they outweigh the cons by a significant mile. But hey, I'm just here to outline the pros and cons, and let's start this off with Gibby's strength. Gibby is one of the two defensive legends with two passives, one being the fortified passive, which allows him to take 15% less damage and also doesn't get slowed when he gets hit by a bullet. And his next passive is his gun shield, which allows him to block incoming damage from enemy bullets, which basically gives him an additional 50 HP but will break after taking enough damage, and also blocks grenades. Gibby's next strength is his tactical, which is one of a kind in Apex, his dome shield. It is similar to Bangalore's smoke in a sense. They both allow you to provide cover for your teammates, but unlike Bangalore's smoke, enemies can't spray and pray through Gibby's shield. It blocks bullets and any incoming projectiles and allows you to safely res your teammates and give them cover in open spacing. And there's a saying that a good Gibby doesn't use his dome shield to res his teammate. A good Gibby uses it to prevent his teammates from going down in the first place. Yeah, I'm not a Gibby. My cover isn't being thrown for my brothers, unfortunately. The final strength that Gibby has is his ultimate, which he rains down a defensive bombardment, which allows him to section off a portion of the map with a bombardment of airstrikes. On whichever area he throws his ultimate down, which allows him to deal damage to the enemy, it's basically a better version of Bangalore's ultimate, which is actually effective and useful in most cases. Gibby is ultimately what you want out of a defensive legend. Tanky can provide cover for his team, and his ultimate is good and works well together with his kit. But what is Gibby's weakness? To be honest, he has none with his kit. His kit is perfect, and he's also one of the best defensive legends in the game. But there are two weaknesses to Gibby, not specific to his kit, but the type of playing style you have to adapt to playing Gibby and other defensive legends in this game as well. Those two weaknesses intertwine and also become one thing, which can be said for all defensive legends in solo queue, including Gibby, and I will outline each and every one of them every time in this series when I'm talking about defensive legends. And that's, Gibby requires an insane amount of teamwork to work, and he's the most difficult defensive legend to play, especially when communication is lacking. You now see why I say these two points intertwine, becoming one, because with teamwork you need communication, and for effective communication you need teamwork. Now, talking in depth about his weakness. In the first point, I mentioned that Gibby's tactical is used to provide cover and protection for his teammates from incoming projectiles. But as you know, in Apex, there are multiple different dimensions to this game, and it's not as linear as other games. Throwing your Bubba down to provide cover sounds so simple that even a baby could do it, right? Wrong. You have to communicate with your team when and where you are placing your Bubba. And in solo queue, there is no such thing as communication in casual play with randoms. They do whatever they want and don't care. But as Gibby, you still have to stick with your team, because your kit is built for teamwork and all that good stuff. And we all know it's rare to get random teammates with more than one brain cell. As a Gibby, teamwork is the most important thing for your kit to work to the fullest extent. You also need a lot of information to know when and where to place your bubbles or your ultimate. You also need a lot of information to know when and where to place your bubble or your ult. But in solo queue, this doesn't work as effectively because there isn't much information. So you play more reactively. Instead of using your kit to help your team to defend your spot. You also don't know if your teammates will capitalize off the advantages that your kit will bring to the team. It's not a good thing to rely on your random teammates to win games. This takes away a huge strength from Gibby when not playing with a team that communicates effectively. Gibby is like the focal point of the team. And in pro play, teams always focus on the Gibby more than anyone else in the squad, because Gibby is the queen that your enemy needs to get into check. Once they take out your Gibby, you are left defenseless. You don't have the bubble to protect you. If you are in the open, you are left as sitting ducks, waiting for the inevitable fate of your team getting wiped out. You can argue that Gibby can just use his kit for himself and for himself only in solo, but in reality that isn't how Gibby's kit is meant to be used. Gibby, in my opinion, wasn't meant to be played in solo queue. He was meant for a team. I get why he isn't played much, but how can he be improved to help his solo queue pick rate go up? To be honest, there isn't any buffs that you can give to Gibby. He's already a staple pick in pro play, so you can't really buff him, and if they want to bring up his pick rate in solo queue, they would have to probably rework his kit to play more for himself, which is never going to happen because Apex is meant to be played as a team game and with different legend classes to give a team a more balanced and well-rounded chance of winning games. And seeing that he's already so strong in high rank play and also pro play, he also needs a nerf to lower his pick rate in pro play, something to give teams more counterplay against his down shield, which doesn't involve you and your team sitting and waiting for it to run out. Some nerfs they could give to him is: 1. Reduce or rework his hitbox. Remove the gun shield and make the bubble have HP to be destroyable from bullets. These are just my opinions. They may be bad, but as I said, they are just opinions. And if you have any of your own, please feel free to share them in the comments if you have reached this far in the video. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe for more Apex related content. And until next video, have a great day.